Y ya estamos en el día 104 en la frase del día. Ya es viernes, viernes, me encantan los viernes, todos listos para el fin de semana. No? Okay. Perdón. Today's phrase, it's not really as much of a phrase as somebody wanted to know the differences between flojo, these are all adjectives, but flojo, perezoso, huevón, and I'll add another one, holgazán. Basically, flojo, perezoso, holgazán, and huevón are all used to refer to somebody being lazy. And for the most part, they're synonyms. There might be a nuanced difference for one or the other. I would tell you in Mexico, flojo, especially floja for female, is going to have negative connotations, basically referring to loose morals as well as being lazy. Instead, somebody might say, ay, me da flojera. That is, it gives me laziness to do something. Me da flojera hacer eso. It makes me, I just feel too lazy to do that. But in other countries, they might just say, él es muy flojo. He's just a lazy guy. And the huevón or huevona, I think, for females, that's kind of more offensive. I wouldn't really personally use that. It would offend people that I know. And so that's, it's lazy, but it's really more probably with people that speak with colorful metaphors, if you will. I think it's more of a Mexican word as well. So you might avoid huevón or huevona so as not to offend somebody, and you might stick to perezoso or flojo, maybe holgazán, although holgazán only refers to they don't want to work. Whereas flojo and perezoso, I believe, are more just kind of a general laziness. Hope that answered your question. Gracias por la pregunta. Y nos vemos pronto. Adiós.